Hey, what's up, everybody? Gabe here from Gabe's Music Discography, bringing you another video. Today's video, I'm going to do this one new little bit, I guess, or series called Four of a Kind, where it's about an artist or band who wrote four albums in a row that are just, for me, not perfect, but pretty darn close to perfect. Like, I could put them on anytime. You can listen to them front to back without skipping. You're not worried about, oh, this song's coming up next. It's all great stuff. Could be the first four albums, could be their last four, could be albums right in the middle. There's no EPs in here, it's all just straight up albums. It's yeah, just four great albums front to back. So yeah, well, you'll see who I'm going to talk about. I'll have it on the title, but yeah, this is a pretty easy one too. And some people might even say like their first five albums are just like the five of the best albums. Some of them, I thought like Slayer, their first, was it Rain and Blood, South of Heaven, Seasons in the Abyss. That was the only three I really like from Slayer. 311. Music, Grassroots, and 311, and then Transistor came along, and that's a song or an album that I could skip tons of stuff on that. So with some close ones, Yeah, they almost got in here, but Mosquito came out as their fourth album, and it was like, nope, it's not gonna make the cut of Four of a Kind. So Four of a Kind. It's like I said, it's gonna be in the title, but a pretty easy one. Metallica. Kill 'Em All, Ride the Lightning, Master of Puppets, and Justice for All. I mean, you guys all know that these are some of the. They had so many followers after they came out with this stuff. So many people were like, "Holy shit, man, that stuff's awesome! I'm gonna let's take our band in that direction." Like I said, in the two, the fifth one, the Black Album for me just doesn't cut it. It's I don't know. It's very polarizing, I guess you could probably say, in the music community. Some people love it, some people hate it, some people kind of like it, like me. I guess there's some stuff on there I like, but I don't like everything on there, and it just didn't make the cut of, well, that would have been five of a kind, but there is no such thing as five of a kind, so we're only doing four of a kind. So my Metallica. I was thinking of this and I couldn't remember because I have an older brother. So he had, we used to be out, we were outside all the time in the summertime, and we used to listen to music out there. And I remember he had a cassette copy of Master of Puppets. I don't know if he recorded it from the vinyl onto a cassette, because that's what it was a copy. And like I said, I don't remember. Because I think Master came out in 86 in like May or March. Can't remember. And I can't remember if we were listening to it then in the summer of 87 or the summer of 88. I can't remember exactly which year it was. But I remember hearing it and being like, what in the hell is this? This is awesome. Because I think before that, I was probably MTV, some of that harder stuff was coming. I remember I was 10 years old, but I was into the first Poison album, There's some cute songs on there, right? Probably Def Leppard, Guns N' Roses when they came out in 87 with Appetite. I mean, that changed everything again too. But so somewhere in there is kind of when I first started listening to Metallica. And I remember in 88 when Injustice came out, he got the double album, and I remember hearing that and just being blown away again, just how great that was. But yeah, so that's kind of how I got into Metallica, and then I got big into Metallica. My bedroom was posters and pictures, from like Circus Magazine and Parade. Pictures all over, posters all over, tapestries. Like, I think pretty much, I would say probably 80% of my room was covered in pictures, and it was all Metallica, no other bands. It was just straight up Metallica. That's how big I was into Metallica. When I started Playing drums. I didn't start playing too Metallica, but I somewhere in probably junior high, I guess, right? Eighth grade, maybe seventh, probably eighth, between eighth and ninth grade is when I started like playing like I started playing like stuff from Kill 'Em All, like Am I Evil and Blitzkrieg. That was kind of maybe the easier stuff to play. Then as I got older, I got into more of the, as you get older, you get better and you start playing. I started learning stuff off here. I didn't really do a whole lot with this, but I remember when this, I didn't start playing this till probably 8 or 9 years ago. I just never, I don't know what, for whatever reason, but I finally got into it and I was able to play the whole thing. But that was like 8 or 9 years ago when I started learning that, and I haven't played drums for about 2 years. It's worn down, and everything is in my office. My office here is all music stuff, and there's no real. It's more of a listening. I'd rather just sit back and enjoy the music than playing loud drums. And this, my heart is not in it anymore. So, it's yeah. So like I said, I was playing Metallica stuff at an early age, and like I said, big into Metallica. Yeah, so I mean, I don't know. I'm sure these everybody's talked about these, so it's not really any kind of new news about these albums or anything, but it's kind of just me talking about how much I was into Metallica and how much I listened to them. And then you get into the other stuff like Anthrax and Slayer and stuff, but my heart was always with these first four here. And then Garage Days EP also. That was when they got Jason Newsted, and that came out in between here, between Master and Injustice. I remember I saw them in 92, May of 92, for I guess with the Black Album tour. I don't even can't remember the name of the tour. And man, I was trying to think. I don't know if I've ever seen them after that. It's so weird. I was trying to think. I might have. I have some ticket stubs somewhere, but I'm like, I don't know if I've ever seen Metallica besides that show in 92. I'll have to look into that a little more, but that could be. I've only seen them once, maybe. I could have saw them with my brother around my birthday in Grand Forks, North Dakota, about 6 years ago, but man, I can't do Metallica, and I can't do the way that James sings now. And then Lars on the drums. I was thinking about too, Lars, he like. You think about these drummers, how they get just better and better. Like they practice and they get better as they age. But Lars, like, he seems like he didn't practice or something, and he just got worse. And he didn't care enough. His heart's not in the drums, I guess. So his drumming has just gone down so far. And with the new album, 72 Seasons, I was just listening to it last week, I think. I swear, man, he's only got like three songs where he's got drum fills. The rest of the stuff is just hitting the snare. And it's all, you've seen all the videos and stuff making fun of him. And yeah, his drumming just, like I said, he just didn't practice, I guess, or didn't care enough about it to improve. So his drumming really, I think, kind of brought some of the stuff down. And then Kirk, like every solo is goddamn wah pedal, wah pedal. Sorry. Every solo is just with the wah pedal. I mean, the dude cannot play without the wah-wah pedal. So yeah, 72 Seasons, that's their last one. It just came out like a year ago. Yeah, I don't know, man. I mean, obviously it's not going to compare to this because that's 40 years ago. These were like kids when this stuff came out. Yeah, so I mean, these have been talked about ad nauseam, like I said, ad nauseum. So but yeah, real heavy, like the what is it, the new wave of British metal, this like turned that on its head and kicked its ass, I guess that's something you'd say right here. Well, I think this no, this was gonna be, yeah, this I think it was originally gonna be called Metal Up Your Ass, wasn't it? But they wouldn't let them, the record company. Yeah, it's very, I mean, what do you say about it? It's rock, it's heavy, not heavy metal, but it's not British Invasion. It's heavier than that. It's great stuff. Like I said, I could listen to this anytime. Same, you know, all these. That's what all these are about. This is, I don't think, as raw as Kill 'Em All. Songs are a little more complex, maybe a little more, you know, a little bit as your songwriting gets better, so you know, your confidence grows and things like that. So, and then obviously, I think these are probably, if you ask people, like, these are probably their, well, I don't know if this is, man. I don't know how people feel about this. I know, I think a majority of people would probably say Master of Puppets, and this is like the peak. I don't know. Is it really thrash? I don't know. They get lumped into that thrash, but I don't know if it's thrash. But this is like peak. If you want the ultimate, if you know, the Slayer, the Megadeth, Anthrax, Exodus, Overkill, all those bands, I think they would. This is probably like the peak of the mountain of all those albums from all those. And people are gonna obviously have different opinions. But I think this is probably the peak of all of those, right? All of those heavy metal, thrash metal bands. This is like the peak album. I mean, so many great songs on here. Every song on here is great. And then you have, well, quick little side note. Back, I'm assuming it was probably the early 90s or late 80s. I was wearing Metallica. I still have the shirt, actually. It's probably, yeah. This, and on the back was like the Damage Incorporated, where it's like a couple skulls with, I think, some, not axes, but clubs, you know, with the spikes hanging out. And I was in line, I still remember this, and I was in line at the grocery store, and some old lady behind me goes, she goes, "Oh, your shirt is so colorful." 'Cause if you've seen that shirt, it's, you know, very, it's a black shirt, but it's bright colors, you know, and yeah, it's always stuck in my memory. But it's like, oh, it's a very bright shirt. It's skulls and, you know, clubs with spikes hanging out, and I think it says like Damage Incorporated on the bottom or something. But yeah, so that's a little thing about that. And then you have the ultimate, I think, I guess maybe it's not the ultimate, but just complex. Putting their writing skills, putting their musicianship at like the as far as they could go, I think, in that. And it's just, yeah, I mean, all these songs are killer songs on here too. It's different than this, you know, I mean, obviously it's different, but it's, this is more heavy metal, I guess, maybe in a way, and this is more, this is almost maybe more focused on the playing of the instruments and the playing of the music, as it's not really the music. I don't know if that makes sense. Like, this is like just about playing hard music, playing, you know, playing the music. Or, like I said, it's hard to explain. It's more about the music, and this is more about like the playing of the music. And if that makes any sense, it's just, it reminded me of the Dream Theater, right? Under the band that's got, you know, the guy up there, the guitar, that's can't move because he's so focused on the guitar. You know, it's kind of not quite like that, but it's kind of like this in a way, where they're really focused on getting the notes right and doing all this complex stuff, where this is more just like kick you in the ass, I guess, kick you in the head, you know. So that's the kind of a difference between these two. And I think that's, you know, that James talked about, that's why they went with the Black Album after this, because they just were at concerts and people were just standing there because there's no real mosh parts to this, I guess. And people, and James said he saw that and was like, you know what, man, we got to go back to getting kids dancing and banging their heads and stuff. So that's kind of what with the Black Album. But like I said, that one for me, I remember getting it, and I guess I remember getting it, but I don't remember my experience because it was so long ago. But I would say I probably wasn't like disappointed in the album, but it was probably, it took a while, I think. If this is weird, Metallica, and then the Black Album came out, it was totally something totally different, and you either had to adjust to it, or you call them sellouts, or you just didn't listen to it anymore. I've tried every once in a while, maybe once every 2 years, I'll break it out and listen to it just because it's so different. It's not something that I particularly care for a whole lot anymore. Like I said, I don't remember my full experience with it because it was so long ago, but man, it's nothing compared to these. These are the ultimate, again, that word. I'm using that word a lot with Metallica, but people, obviously say that these are the best. But there's obviously opinions. I know people talk about Exodus should be in there. Testament should maybe be in there in the big four. But yeah, so that's my kind of Metallica, my experience with them. Stuff I can still listen to. It's 40 some years old. When did Kill 'Em All came out in 83? So 41 years old. July of 84. Like I said, I think May or March of 86, and then this came out in September of 88. So boy, yeah, and then nothing really good after that, huh? I know people like Load and Reload and Hardwired and stuff, but I've tried with that stuff. I'm not gonna say I hate it, and I'm not gonna bash them or anything because they're artists, they can do whatever they want. But this is just my where I stopped my Metallica experience. Garage Days is mixed in there too. So yeah, so I guess that's the end of it. I guess it's not really, like I said, everybody's talked about Metallica so much. Everybody knows Metallica, so it's not like any, I'm not like opening up your minds and your minds aren't blown with all the information that I'm giving you. It's more about my experience and it's kind of kicking off this four of a kind thing where, and this is a pretty easy one. There's another one too that I think is kind of an easy one too, but I'm not going to talk about that yet. Maybe next month I'll do this again. But my Metallica, I have the four box sets that that came out in the past 5, 6 years. I'll talk about those someday. I'll get around to doing that. Yeah, so my Metallica or my first four of a kind, is kind of a no-brainer for a lot of people, but Metallica, Kill 'Em All, Ride Lightning, Master Puppets, and Justice for All. Yeah, four of a kind. What four of a kind is gonna be next? I guess you'll have to wait and see because who knows, maybe I'll never do it again. I don't know. I'm gonna do it again though. I'm just teasing you. All right. Thanks for watching.